I'm here with Grandmaster Temur Kuibakarov. Temur, you won against Gukesh today. Is this the biggest win of your career?
Yes, it's the biggest win for me during my career. I also won Wojtaszek on the Chess Olympiad, but it's my second 2700 win.
Who was the first one?
Wojtaszek.
Wojtaszek, when was that?
In Chess Olympiad, Chennai.
Ah, wow. Okay, today's game, I think you got an advantage out of the opening. And although you were better, it was not so easy to win, right? Your knight on c4 was strong, but his bishop was also good.
Yes, so Gukesh played this rare move, sword g6. I wasn't expecting him. I guess he wanted to get similar to Rosalima pawn structures because he played a6 and I could take bishop c6, dc, and it's a kind of Rosalima. But I decided to play more dynamic game with bishop a4. And later on, he surprised me with move c5. So after move c5, I was not sure how to play, but I thought DC is the most practical way to proceed because I exchanged some pieces and I think I keep slight initiative. So after DC, bishop c3, I thought bishop takes c3 was slight inaccuracy. I thought bishop e6 first was a bit more precise. After bishop c6, queen c3, queen b6, I got a pleasant choice. So I could go queen f6 or I could go also rook c1 for blockade on the dark squares. So I wasn't sure about what to do. And at the end, I decided to play for attack, so I played queen e6. And after queen c7, knight c3, again, Gukesh played a risky move c5. In my opinion, maybe bishop e6 is simpler, but c5 also logical move. So after c5, again, I had a choice. This time I can go knight d5 and get this position after knight d5, ed, bishop b7, and then say d6. Or rook ad1 first, and after rook d8, d6. But I thought maybe include knight e5 first. So I played knight e5, and after bishop b7, this position already, I think, kind of equal, objectively. No, he played b4 first, knight d5, knight d5, ed, then bishop b7, rook ad1, and queen d8. So first I thought I have advantage due to the active pieces, but it was objectively, I think, fine for him. So after queen f3, he played queen c7, queen g3, queen d6, f4. So I got a decent, stable position. And after rook ad8, I played knight c4, queen f6, d6. So here, I think the easiest way to make a draw was bishop c6, and just go bishop b5, and just take the pawn on d6. But instead, he played a bit risky move, rook fe8. Then I played queen f2. So here, I thought I already slightly better. And my hope was that he played queen f5. I thought again, maybe again he should go bishop c6, queen c5, bishop b5, but it's already a little bit dangerous for him. So he played queen f5, but then it was my idea to push d7. And after rook d7, knight d6, I have a nice four. So of course he didn't play that, he went rook f8, I played rook d6. Here I thought already have good position, but I think he still could play, let's say, f6. But instead he played rook d7 and sacrificed his queen.
So did he miss knight e3 or?
I think no, actually. I think he thought that his position already is unpleasant and maybe he thought he get a very good practical chance, maybe even a draw. But in this case already after knight e3, rook d6, knight e5, gf, queen c5, he played rook d2. And maybe he misses that I have just side move rook e1. And actually it's pretty unpleasant for black to play. We also already in slight time trouble, so it was not easy to calculate everything. So he played the natural rook g2 check, king f1, rook takes h2. Here I played queen takes f5. I thought it's maybe the most ambitious move, because so after rook c8, the move queen d7. And after rook h1 check, king e2, rook c2 check. Here was funny trap. If I go king d3, he has bishop e4 check. So I have to go king d1. And here I think Gukesh made maybe last mistake, because I thought rook b2 is possible in this position. Yeah. So I wasn't sure about this position, yeah, because after queen d8 check, king g7, queen d4, king g8, it was very funny, but after queen takes b2, he has some bishop f3 check ideas. And let's say after king king c2, rook h2, he retreat the queen. It was a very strange position. I'm exchange up, but he also has h pawn, so I thought this is the best chance. How he played in the game, I think it's just rook e1, king e1, this position just objectively, I think, already hopeless.
Wow. That was very well described, the entire game. Are you feeling very happy right now, or how is your feeling?
Yeah, of course, I'm happy. Also, I think Gukesh could make a draw if he'll play bishop c6. So it's honestly a lucky win. I don't feel that I played better than him, but I was just more lucky. Something happens.
And you are right now, what's your live rating? Do you have any idea, like your published rating and so on?
So hopefully I crossed 2600 in, wow. in this month. Yeah, but still I have two rounds to play.
Yes.
But yeah.
But would you be like the first player ever from Australia to cross 2600?
Actually, Anton Smirnov also crossed it, but after he switched to main job, and right now he don't play chess, so right now I think he dropped rating a bit, but yeah, so I will be first ranked player in Australia. Hopefully.
That's amazing. Tell us a bit about the chess culture in Australia. Is it easy to sort of pursue chess there, because not too many strong players are from there? We all know about Ian Rogers, who is a legend of Australian
legend,
chess.
For sure, he loves chess a lot. Yeah, he had I think heart stroke, and after that he doctors forbid him to play chess. So, but he still loves chess. He commenting every time, yes. doing annotations. But chess in Australia is not so easy, because it's very expensive to travel overseas, and it's also very far to travel overseas. So it's hard to be in the best shape in the first rounds. But I try to work on chess like 8 hours, like a chess professional. But I would say my playing routine is not professional, because I don't play enough chess tournaments. But I hope to play more in the
upcoming. So what do you do apart from chess? Do you also study?
Not really. I'm doing lessons also. I'm giving chess lessons to promising kids. And that's mainly it. I just do work
on chess. Teaching others and playing. These
yes,
are the
exactly,
two things you
exactly.
do.
Exactly. Also teaching talented kids. Actually, we have a lot of Indian promising kids who just stay in Australia nowadays, so I help to them as well.
You teach
so,
them?
Yeah, I have a lot of Indian students. So.
Wow, that's so nice to know.
Actually, in India, I think chess is just booming. I was so happy to play in Chennai. It was like so nice to organize it.
You enjoyed it?
Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
You were playing on the top board for Australia?
I played on the second board, yeah.
Second board?
Yes. Yeah, I enjoyed my experience in Chennai, definitely. It was very nice.
Right, and do you, what is your aim in chess? Next aim, you cross 2600 now.
Yes, so I try to get better, so try to respect chess, play according to the position and just improve. And I think I love chess, so I guess results will come at some point.
That's wonderful to know. And is there anyone who trains you?
I work with Alexei Dreyev, also from Russia. We doing some training, we did some training camps, and also I worked with Igor Kovalenko before the war, but right now he unfortunately fighting for his country, so he not able to play chess, which is understandable, but I hope everything will be great with him.
Well, Temur, we are seeing you how well you are playing recently.
Thank
and
you.
We hope that you will cross 2700
Thank
soon.
Thank you so much. Thank
Congratulations.
You. Thank you.